Washington Pod presents Earl Nightingale.
Whenever something important like the work you want to do or the person you want to marry comes up in your life, think in terms of what you can give to the situation, not just what you can get. It's what we give to a situation that will make it succeed or fail, not what we receive. Our sowing is what we put in, and that's what will determine the success or failure of the venture. Now, I hope we can agree on this idea because it's at the bottom of everything we do. The sowing is up to us, but we must reap the harvest of our sowing, and it will always be in proportion to how much of ourselves we put into the project all the years of our lives. You have so many interesting things to do and so much to live for, so much to see, smell, taste, and experience, and now is the time to begin. Nothing happens until we act upon what we've learned. It's amazing how much we learn when we do things personally. Just reading about them or listening to me talk about them won't do a thing until you actually begin to do them yourself. We want to live rich, rewarding, satisfying, challenging lives, doing what we most love to do for the benefit of others. If we do that, we needn't worry about anything else. All the things we need and want will come to us quite naturally in their own good time. And we'll learn that it's not the things we have that make us great or small. It's what we are. It's what we become as human beings. So let's begin. Let's begin today to become the person we want to become. In the fine book, The Courage to Create, by Dr. Rollo May, he says, "In human beings, courage is necessary to make being and becoming possible. An assertion of the self, a commitment, is essential if the self is to have any reality." Now, he's saying that in order to be something, to become something, we need courage. We need a commitment to something if we're to have any reality. Now, George Bernard Shaw wrote in his play Man and Superman, "This is the true joy in life, the being used for a purpose recognized by yourself as a mighty one. The being a force of nature instead of a feverish, selfish little clod of ailments and grievances, complaining that the world will not devote itself to making you happy." And he went on to write, "I want to be thoroughly used up when I die, for the harder I work, the more I live. I rejoice in life for its own sake. Life is no brief candle to me. It's a sort of splendid torch which I've got hold of for the moment, and I want to make it burn as brightly as possible before handing it on to future generations." Living is so much fun when we go about it the right way. And it's actually easier in the long run. There's plenty of room at the top. We need the best that's in you if, as a nation, we're to successfully compete in today's and tomorrow's world. Believe me, we need you. We need you as an educated, literate, thinking, imagining, creating, hard-working human being. Become that, and we'll give you everything you could possibly want in return.